Dumba fires high and wide. And they score! Parise on the rebound!
Zach, earlier this season, you put your name on the top of the all-time goals scored list by Minnesota-born players when you scored goal number 341. And you, maybe as much as any player in the NHL, are known for scoring goals one way, around the net, within close range of the net, in the blue paint. How would you describe yourself as a goal scorer?
That sums it up pretty good. I mean, I think I've learned, learned my niche out there and where I'm good at scoring. That's, I guess, where I've kind of made my living.
Off the post, Parise scores!
When you put your name on top of that Minnesota list, was there a player or players that when you sit back and look at it and say, wow, my name is above that guy's name?
Neil Broughton was the one that stuck out. I mean, I always watched him when he was with the Stars, and I guess I had thought in my mind that he scored a lot more goals than that. So I was kind of surprised to see being ahead of him on the list.
We're going to take a look at some of your goals. Just kind of have you explain to us what's going through your mind here. Here's a goal against Tampa this year. When you start to battle for it, I mean, how much of your positioning changes as the puck moves around in the offensive zone?
I think there's certain times you're looking to screen. There's certain times you're looking for deflections, and other times you're trying to jump on rebounds. But it's a lot of it is body positioning and timing. I think there you're just trying to put Strowman to sleep almost, and then all of a sudden there's that split second where he's paying attention to something else and someone else, and I was able to box him out and get body position on him. And the D-men are pretty big and strong. I think there's certain times you almost avoid engaging in a one-on-one battle with them. It's science. I'm not going to out-muscle these guys. I think right there, you look, he's trying to front the puck when our D-man gets it, and that's kind of that split second where it opens up for me.
Over 340 goals, how many of them do you think finish with some of your body part laying on the ice in the blue paint?
Probably about 70%, and 90% probably came from in the blue paint.
Parise scores!
So here's another one where you're fighting for position, this one against the Sharks. And here you're on a power play, so you've got a little more space. But it's still the situation the same. In this case, because you have more space, are you thinking more screen at first and then reacting to rebound?
I remember I lost my voice the day before from, I think, horse racing on the plane. but I told the guys on the par, I was like, guys, I can't yell, so I'm going to bang my stick. And you see me beaver tapping in front of the net. Like, but I think the way they were killing, where they don't really pay attention to the net front guy, they more so want to front the one-timers, and they want to front the guys that have the puck. So I always tell our D or our wingers or the guys on the sides, just float one in there. Just float one in there. Nino and I will have a two-on-one or a little small little breakaway in front of the net. And I always say, if we can get it into that area, we'll outnumber them. And that's a perfect example. And it's a two-on-one, and Dumbs is coming down the weak side. It's a three-on-one in front of the net.
Got this one, I believe, is against the Jets in the playoffs last year.
I remember that one. Morrissey's pretty much locking onto me, and I mean, Mikko can walk that thing in right there the way they're killing him. Again, we timed it really well where I was able to push off him at the right time, and Mikko found me at the right time with a really good pass through some skates. You almost want that D to feel like I'm out of the play. You just need that moment of separation, getting your stick free.
You and Mikko have played together a lot now, and you've talked about it on a couple of these goals, getting a sense for what they're giving you. Do you feel like the two of you have a better connection now than you've ever had throughout your times here?
I feel like it, yeah. I think last year when they started putting us together and we had a really good end of the season in the playoffs and into this year, I think we talk a lot on the bench, always in a constructive way of, hey, I'm here. If you see it, they're leaving this open, you know. And so we've developed a really good line of communication, trying to help each other out. And I want him to do well. He wants me to do well. So it works.
Final thought. We're just looking at a few clips here of the price you have to pay around the blue paint. And you talked about the fact that you know that's where you have to go to score goals. You know you're going to take sticks in the spine, you're going to get tripped, you're going to get punched in the back of the head. What's life like in the blue paint?
It's hard, and you get sore, and but it's rewarding getting a rebound goal. It's what I've done my whole life.